Hello everyone and welcome back to White Pine Racing, to the second part of the video dedicated to the expansion muffler for two-stroke engines. After we saw what are the elements that compose an expansion muffler and what aspects every element influences with its dimension, let's talk about two essential parameters for the calculation of this kind of exhaust, which is the total length and maximum diameter. What I'm proposing today is a theoretical study because I won't take into account the speed variations in noise propagations relating to the temperature. The study subject is a fictional 200cc propeller with the piston's diameter at 64 and stroke 62. But let's take a closer look at all the necessary parameters for the calculation of the muffler. Bore 64mm, stroke 62 for a total of 199.45 cubic centimeters. Geometrical compression ratio 12 to 1, exhaust phase 190, transfer phase 130, ignition's minimal timing 15 degrees before the top dead point. Supply reed valve to the crankcase and 36mm carburetor. Every muffler we'll take into exam have the same proportions. 50% header, 50% diffuser, 10% belly, 25% baffle. Setting a single parameter for all the mufflers helps us to compartmentalize which is the aim of this study. In fact, our objective is to observe the variations only relating to the length and only relating to the diameter. After we've all seen the theoretical data, let's turn on our virtual workbench on. Let's take our virtual mufflers. And let's get on our fantasy motorcycle. By observing the three mufflers that we named exhaust 1, exhaust 2 and exhaust 3, you can see how the length, but not the proportions, change. In fact, the diffuser cone is 450 in the first exhaust, 425 in the second and 400 in the third. The final diameter and the initial diameter will stay constant instead, just like the belly. By observing this comparative graph, we can appreciate the differences between each muffler. If we take the medium length one, 850mm, as a reference, we can see that it manages to get the engine at a maximum power of 25 horsepower and 10,000 RPM. I would like to point out two aspects here. First is the engine's performance before peak power. With a longer muffler, the curve appears more swollen, fuller, and the arc of use wider. Vice versa, with a shorter muffler, the curve is not as swollen on the and the engine's performance gets worse before the torque speed. And also, the arc of use tightens. The other aspect I wanted to point out was how power, after its peak, drops differently. With a longer muffler, we'll have power that drops not as fast, while with a shorter muffler, we'll have power dropping faster. This happens because the longer muffler holds warmer gas, and so by seeing the final exit diameter on the muffler being smaller, it tends to make the muffler work better over the maximum power ratio, as I explained in the first video. We can explore this matter further. By shortening the muffler, the engine settles on a higher ratio, and it can perform better, although not as linear as the shortening. In fact, by taking the 900mm one, we have 34 horsepower at 9500 rpm, the 851, 35 and 10,000, the 800, 35 and 5, 10,000 and 500, we see that the tune range increases linearly. On the other hand, the peak power increases not linearly, and at the delivery expense. The fact that the engine's power increases in a negative, not linear way is caused by the fact that even though we tuned it to 500 rpm higher, by making a shorter muffler, since we didn't increase the maximum diameter of the belly, we prevent the engine from improving its respiratory capabilities. Let's now observe the exhaust 4, 5 and 6. Same length, 850 mm, but with a different maximum diameter. Exhaust 4, 120, exhaust 5, 125, exhaust 6, 130. All three mufflers have the starting and ending diameters equally long, 35 at the beginning, 21 at the end. The exhaust 5, by the way, is identical to the exhaust 2, so it will have the same curve that will act as a compass relatively to the length. By observing the comparative graph that features the mufflers with the same length but different diameters, we can see what variations are present relatively to the power curve. Our reference will always be the exhaust 5, which is the medium one compared to the other two. So, we'll always get a maximum power of 35 at 10,000 rpm. It's interesting to point out that the power delivery is always the same because the length is the same. So, since it's total length that determines the tune range, we'll have different power, but always at the same range. But anyway, what's happening here? We see with a smaller diameter, we'll have inferior maximum power, a fuller delivery curve, and a longer over-revving. Because being the muffler smaller, the gas heats up more and meets a larger exit diameter. On the opposite hand, with a larger muffler diameter, we'll have a more floppy delivery curve before the max power range and less pronounced over-revving because the gas is colder. In this case, I hypothesized that the engine had sufficient breathing capabilities to take advantage of a bigger belly. And so, in power terms, the engine's delivery is not linear in this case as well. But it's still positive, because rather than having 36 horsepower, by increasing the belly by 5 mm, it'll get to 36.5. This happens because by increasing the belly's diameter, the two cones' corners will increase as well, both the diffuser and the baffle. Therefore, they'll generate stronger, but also shorter waves. So, very fit for higher tune ranges. The sum of these two parameters, that is the bigger diameter, which allows better airflow and wider cones corners, our results will be an increase in positive nonlinear power. Obviously, also by shortening the muffler, we'll obtain cones with wider corners while keeping the same proportions. However, without increasing the belly's diameter, we'll never get an increase in the power more than linear or non-linear. We'll always get an increase in power less than linear exactly because by not increasing the muffler's diameter, we're stopping the engine from breathing better, even if it had the chance. That's all for today, I hope I could be of help, goodbye and see you on the next video. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember, White Run Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.